for the final time at the 32nd Olympiad. We welcome you to the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre for the gold medal match. It is the pinnacle of men's water polo, and between two European heavyweights, a frantic four quarters of water polo coming up as Greece take on Serbia. Well, Greece, who are second in the rankings currently, is their highest ever position. Their best performance was a fourth place back in 2004. Hard to believe that they've never been on an Olympic podium before. And the way they celebrated after that semi-final victory, you would have thought they'd won the gold medal there and then. It was almost an outpouring of relief that they'd finally got the monkey off their back and managed to get into a final. But if they want to take gold, they're going to have to stop Serbia winning back-to-back gold medals. The Serbs, who took gold in Brazil 5 years ago after an 11-7 win over Croatia, have their eyes on a double gold medal. Well, here are the Greek players that have propelled them to this final.
And number 12, Angelos Vlahopoulos.
Angelos Vlahopoulos, one of the drivers in the team. Most important players that really get things going for them in the pool. Big physical side, good defence. And they've got a great goalkeeper in Emmanuel Zadavis behind them as well. A lot of these Serbs won the gold medal 5 years ago. You've got 3 5-time Olympians within their ranks. Dusan Mandic has played over 200 internationals now. Nikola Dedovic, one of their drivers. Just the two left-handers, Mandic being one of them.
Number five, Jordi Lazic.
Jordi Lazic in his first Olympic Games.
Dusko Pietlovic.
Dusko Pietlovic, one of the five-timers.
Number seven, Drahinja Rasovic.
Rasovic, another debutant. Milan Aleksic. 11 goals in 5 Olympic appearances for him now.
Number 10 and captain, Filip Filipovic.
There's the talisman, Filip Filipovic.
Number 11, Andrea Kruljanovic.
10 goals already in this edition of the Olympic
12,
Games.
His
goals
Mitrovic
have helped propel Serbia to the final.
And number 13, Branislav Mitrovic.
Branislav Mitrovic is the goalkeeper. The Serbians know all about winning. They have been strong throughout. They have lost a couple of times in this edition of the Games, to Spain and to Croatia.
Please welcome our referees.
Greece remain unbeaten.
From the USA,
here are the two
Michael
referees there, the men in charge of keeping order. Michael Goldenberg, Spain, one of the most experienced referees in water polo, and Chevy Bush from Spain. You'll see what a difficult job they have once we get underway.
Please welcome our
Despite the fact there's no fans here, you can feel the tension around this water polo arena. There's the FINA delegates, Mark Koganov, former referee himself. And now we will have the two national anthems, Greece, followed by that of Serbia.
The anthems of Greece and Serbia.
Girisha to Serbia no konka desu.
Thank you. such a proud moment for Greece and Serbia as they prepare to contest this gold medal clash at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre. The Serbians there, four players in their fifth Olympics, so much experience through Prolanovic, Pjedlovic, Aleksic, and also Captain Fantastic, the man with the number 10 cap, and that is Filip Filipovic. The Greek side here, six players for Greece here at their first Olympic Games, part of a rebuilding stage for the Greeks, which has certainly paid off. One of those players, Alejandros Papanastasiou, he's just 22 years of age. He scored seven goals in the tournament and has picked up nine fouls. That will be the key. The fouls are reset, but the issue will be with defence as we take a look at some of the Serbian players. Mr. Filipovic, he was responsible for getting into this gold medal match with a last-ditch, last 30-second shot against the Spaniards in the semi-final. They are our players. So much at stake. Greece will win its first water polo medal for men's at the Olympic Games. The big question is, will it be gold or will it be silver? They'll have to rely on so much firepower, especially from their captain, number five, Yanis Fontoulis, who's second on the scoreboard for the Greeks with 14 goals. He lives in Budapest now, but has been given the proud task of carrying the flag at the closing ceremony in just a few hours from now. The task at hand, though, is this gold medal match. It is Serbia, former champions from Rio, and know how to win gold up against Greece, chasing its first gold medal in a team sport at the Olympic Games. This is exciting stuff. Results for Greece coming through. A victory over Hungary. In fact, undefeated throughout the tournament. Just a slight scare against Italy. 6-6. So a young side, undefeated, about to play the match of their lives for their country to try and win gold for water polo, but also the first time for a team sport. They'll be relying on several players, including their young goalkeeper, the 23-year-old Zadavis. He's been outstanding. The Serbians, a couple of scares along the way, a loss to Croatia and an opening loss also to Spain, but certainly found some form in the quarterfinals against Italy and were outstanding in their semi-final. Keep a lookout also for the number two for Serbia. Dusan Mandic is one of two left-handers in the Serbian lineup, as we expect to see some animated work from the Greek coach Theo Vlachos and Dusan Savic. He knows how this unfolds. He was there when they won gold just 5 years ago, and he's chasing back-to-back medals with his teammates. The coaches can only do so much. It will come down to these players to try and fulfill their Olympic dream.
There is Emmanuel Zadivas, who's been superb so far for Greece in the competition. They battle their way past the Hungarians in the semi-final 9-6. They saw off Montenegro in the quarters with a 6-goal winning margin. They really have been impressive and maybe surprised one or two people. But we're ready for the first swim off. First sprint to gain control of the ball in the gold medal match. It will be Jenna Dunias for Greece. And for Serbia, Razovic. Here we go then. 32 minutes. The frantic action to come. First 8 minute quarter. There's the starting lineup for the Serbs, who have first control of the ball. They're in the dark caps. First touch for Filip Filipovic. One of those four five-time Olympians in the Serbian team. And the first attack breaks down. So Greece with a chance to move forward. It was Skoumpakis with a steal. There is their starting lineup. Skoumpakis, one of the centre-backs in the team.
Skoumpakis, one of the young guns as well, just 22 years of age, lives in Kania. He loves that centre-back position, likes to direct play, also likes to get involved early. Good shot, what a start, outstanding stuff.
Well, the first exclusion, Milan Aleksic, has been punished by the opening goal of the final from Skoumpakis. So Greece have taken the lead.
That's where he likes to shoot from, down that left-hand side of the pool. Had all the players in front of him. Also needed to get through Branislav Mitrovic. Didn't have much trouble doing that. So Greece take a lead in this gold medal match, and that will do their confidence tremendously.
Well, they scored 50% of their counter-attack of their power plays with the extra player in the semi-final. 7 out of 14, so that's a good start for them. But Serbia straight back on the offensive. You know they're not going to let you get too far away. Shot whizzes wide. It took a touch on the way through. So it will still be Serbia's ball.
Looked a little frustrated there, Mandic, didn't he? Almost just wanted to get rid of it and have a go. But look at the wall of defence from the Greek players. That is outstanding. So much height, so early. Inspirational defence from Greece early in this match.
Into 2 metres. It's going to be a foul. It was Jusko Pietlovic that was drawing the foul, so the exclusion for Skoumpakis. So the man who scored the goal is now out. And an extra player goal for Serbia, their first of the match. And it's the man who drew the foul, Pietlovic, that gets the opening goal for the Serbians.
He placed himself perfectly, Pietlovic. Had to work hard as well. Look at the defence on him, literally all over him, trying to bring him down. So they lost a player. It was gorgeous delivery, a nice pass, and then an open goal. So at the outset of this game, it looks as though we could be witnessing a high-scoring match, plenty of attacking opportunities, and both sides making the most of a player being excluded.
16th appearance for Greece at an Olympic Games. It is hard to believe that they've never achieved better than fourth place, which they did in Athens in 2004. There's no foul in the hole this time. Clean steal from the Serbians. It was Randalovic, with the steal.
The Greek side have undergone a rebuilding phase, 6 new players at this Olympic Games. Their plan was 6 years ago to not try and target Rio, but to win gold in Tokyo. It's worked for them so far to get to this gold medal match. They will go home with the medal. The question is, will it be gold or silver?
Filipovic, that's what he does best. All the experience coming out, the power of the captain. And Filip Filipovic adds another Olympic goal to his tally. 56 now for him.
It's his 5th Olympics for Filip Filipovic. 660 matches. So another goal for this tournament will take him to 15. He's the one that will lead the way out there. He's the one that won the match for them against Spain. Doesn't have to always be a scoring opportunity, but certainly is a leader. So can Greece fight back here? They've pushed out deep, 7 metres, looking for their perimeter players. There's no one in the middle to go to. Referee took offence then to the defence. So goodbye to Randalovic for 20 seconds. This is where Greece is dangerous.
Keeping their discipline for both sides could be all important. If you get the 3 personal fouls, you are excluded for the rest of the game. So late on, that could be important. That's going over the line.
Make it in.
I think that was in. They'll check it on VAR, but I'm pretty certain that crossed the line.
No surprise. Mitrovic is like, no, that didn't go in.
We'll have a look from this side. They haven't stopped play yet. Did it go over the line? Yes, it looks like it did. So they will have a look at that in a moment.
Both sides affected with their centre-forwards at the moment. They're doing well to escape the clutches of defence to get nice and high. Down the left-hand side of the pool that time. Rasovic, the 29-year-old right-hander with the number 7 cap. He used to play a wider role. He's getting more involved. He has played some centre-forward, but enjoys the wing position. Manages to get away from Aridopoulos, who just couldn't stick with him. And I think they will go back now and have a look at a replay of that initial goal prior to Serbia going to the 3-1 lead.
Yeah, Michael Goldenberg, the American referee, will go and have a look. From that angle, we saw it looked like the ball had crossed the line. Useful addition, VAR. We've seen one or two goals that the goal line judges have missed, such as the speed with which the ball can travel in this game at times.
This was interesting, wasn't it? Popped off his head, hit the top of the cage, came down, hit the back of his head, and then he retrieved it as quickly as possible.
He just lost it for a second, Mitrovic. Don't know if the whole of the ball crossed the line. That's what they'll be just looking at, a little bit of a frame by frame. Now we'll find out what the outcome is.
Goal.
Goal. So goal given, 3-2.
Well, that makes it interesting. That makes it very interesting at all. So the scoreboard has gone back to 2-2. Retrieved that goal that was scored by Rasevich. And it's all locked up at 2-2.
Christodoulos Kolombos with the goal for Greece. So we're back to 2-2. So just when Serbia thought they'd opened up a two-goal lead, we're back to an all-square game again.
Ringing in the changes already is Theodore Vlachos, not hesitant to bring some fresh legs, some strong arms into the game. We'll see lots of bench activity, not just for replacement of players, but due to exclusion fouls. You're only allowed 3 fouls. On the 3rd foul, you will sit the rest of the game out. There's one there. This time they lose Lachopoulos. He'll go poolside. This is Serbia's chance to try and go one up. Once again, it's with Razovic. It's his favourite position. Shot clock counting down. 9 seconds remaining to make the shot. Great patience, excellent delivery. And the whole set activity is working tremendously well for Serbia.
There's Jaksic with his shot in front of goal. The little feint just to make sure that Zadivas was just off balance a little bit. Just went to sway the wrong way, and it was a fairly straightforward finish in the end over the top of the goalkeeper.
He did manage to get up so high, though, didn't he? Look at the reach. It's incredible strength. Takes such core strength to do that. So impressive.
So Serbia do get their 3rd goal after having one chalked off a moment or so ago. Nikola Jaksic with his 10th goal from 18 attempts. Pretty good ratio for him in these Olympic Games so far, but Greece will come back once again.
It's a fast and furious game from the outset. Both sides not hesitant in attacking, taking the shot when the opportunity is there. The defence has been good. Don't be fooled by that with the 3-2 scoreline. Short ball this time denied. The referee saying you can go out for at least 20 seconds to Jaksic. So here come the Greeks.
Prolanovic excluded, so Greece with the extra player. 6-on-5 chance to get back onto level terms, working the cage. It's blocked by Stefan Mitrovic in front of goal. So they haven't taken advantage of that extra player.
There's good defence. He reached high. This is what's happening under the water. You're allowed to jostle and tussle. Not allowed to drag players under or impede with the ball or a player making a shot at goal. So much happening under the water. The referees are trying to keep an eye on it. It's near impossible.
Filipovic trying to get things started again for Greece. There's another foul in front of the cage. That will be a penalty. So denying the goal-scoring opportunity on Stefan Mitrovic that time. It's Konstantinos Marekas that's given away the penalty. So a chance for Serbia with Filip Filipovic. High out of the water. Too much pace on it for Zadivas. And Serbia do have a two-goal cushion in the game, and a little bit of a gap opens up in the scoring.
He loves the penalty gold as the left-handed captain. He'd scored 4 throughout the tournament leading into this. You're allowed to pick any player, and he gets to choose being the captain. There's no hesitancy from his teammates. That was an outstanding shot from the skipper. And that's interesting now, Serbia leading Greece 4-2. This is an important part of play right now for the Greek side in the white caps. They have possession. Looking enthusiastic, they'll bring it out through Anadonius.
Serbia made a relatively slow start to their gold medal winning campaign 5 years ago. They drew their opening 2 group matches against Hungary and Greece. And then they lost to Brazil before finally getting a first win against Australia. They've grown into this tournament this year as well, having lost their opener to Spain. There's another player out of the game, that's Dedovic. Working the ball, working those defenders. Another good save by Branislav Mitrovic.
He read it perfectly, didn't he? He had an idea they'd go to the centre that time as the shot clock was counting down. Didn't have a whole lot of pace on it as Aridopoulos was being thrown under the water. Great defence that time in the field and also by the keeper from Serbia.
Serbia going in search of a 5th goal. And finding that 5th goal as well, a clenched fist from Dusko Pietlovic. And a three-goal cushion now for the defending gold medal champions.
The Greek players have to work out how to shut down Pejetlevic, the centre-forward. In his fifth Olympic Games, he's played more than 450 matches for his country. He had three players around him. None of them could prevent him from scoring the goal. So Pejetlevic goes on his merry way. The Greeks want to win this game. They need to shut down the middle attacking players from Serbia.
On the gold medal winning team in Rio, five European titles, world championship winner on a couple of occasions as well, Dusko Pejetlevic. All that experience is helping carry Serbia through in this opening quarter. We've still got over 2.5 minutes to go. Greece need to make sure that they don't let the Serbians get too far ahead of them. They'd like to try and grab a couple of goals before the end of the first quarter. Good defence again, though. Another good save from Mitrovic.
It was a lovely shot from Velakopas. That was a really, really good shot, but Mitrovic was up to the task. The Greek side have been leading the way in action shots, thanks to their players like Kanadonias and Fontoulis, the captain. They'll need them out there, and they'll need to take a little bit more care on their passing game, because a loose ball like that just chews up the shot clock and adds pressure to the attackers.
Exclusion for Serbia. Greece are 2 from 4 with the extra player at the moment, so 50%. If they could get a goal here, it would just make sure that they're not lagging too far behind, and bounced into the cage by Vlakopoulos.
Second time lucky, wasn't it, for Vlakopoulos? That was outstanding from the number 12. Last time Mitrovic went to the left, this time the ball went to his right. Nice play from Greece. Outstanding stuff.
You can see the tactics, the ball in hand. He was trying to just get those defenders to commit to go one way or the other, which just created that little bit of space for him to find room in the cage. You've got to be precise with keepers, the quality of Branislav Mitrovic, and at the other end, Zadivas.
Two strikes already for Dedovic, so he'll spend some time watching this match. One more, and he'll not take part anymore in this Olympic Games gold medal.
Inside the final 2 minutes of the opening quarter, Serbia back on the attack once again. Players in good positions, Greece struggling to just contain them at the moment. Two players on one, it's left a man free in the centre, it's over the line again. It's a great goal under real pressure there, Jaksic, and he still managed to get a shot in, and he still managed to find a goal.
He only had 1.2 seconds left on the shot clock when he decided to pop that in. Two defenders on him. A decision from Yanadonius to break away and go on the centre forward, anticipating the pass, but instead that one slid right in under the arm. Nice goal. What a time to do it. Leading 6-3 now with a minute 30 to go in the first quarter. An important stage here for this Greek side. They'd like to get a point on the board prior to the quarter time break. Perlanovic is in and Mitrovic is out. That is Branislav's younger brother, who also plays at the Serbian side.
Into 2 metres, that'll be another exclusion for the man who just scored that goal, Jaksic. So the power play again from Greece, approaching the end of the first quarter here. 9 goals already in this opening quarter. We thought it might be a tight game. We didn't think we'd have that many goals, I don't think, in the opening quarter, but good save again, Mitrovic. Beaten away. It was a big, strong hand. It's going to be a turnover foul.
They got the ball back, but I think the referee didn't like the defence then on Columbus. So they'll get an opportunity to attack again. Greece in the white caps, looking for a goal. That was a pass option, but Araropoulos had moved back and wasn't anticipating it. So great work, good defence there from Serbia. That was the initial save. They got possession again, and the next pass went astray. So here come the Serbians, looking for a 7-3 lead. Good deflection.
Good save. Quick reactions needed from these goalkeepers. The ball travels at such a great speed.
has had a remarkable tournament, Hazza Davis, the young goalkeeper from Greece, 23 years of age, part of that new breed of players coming through. Is that a turnover? Greece managed to get the ball. They have to chase it, though. It was a nice little tactic then from Serbia, wasn't it? Shot clock won't start until they touch the ball, though. This is interesting. Could be an opportunity. No other Greek players there to help him out, but retains the possession, does Lachopoulos.
Drew the foul off Mandic. There's an exclusion.
Just
2 metres again. Kalanovic, the man out, and there goes the hooter for the end of the first quarter. Well, Greece got off to a flyer with the opening goal from Skoumpakis, but Serbia eased their way into the match within that first 8 minute section. So at the end of the first quarter, it's Greece 3, Serbia 6.
Greece and Serbia are playing for gold at Tokyo 2020, just 8 minutes into the match, and the Serbians are leading Greece 6-2-3, extra player goals. 2 from 2 for the Serbians, so that means the Greek side will have to watch their discipline when a player is being excluded at this stage. If the Serbians are in an attacking opportunity, they are scoring 100% of the time. So Theodore Vlachos, a few words of wisdom to his team. We need to play like the champions. I know you are. The same side that was undefeated coming into this gold medal match. At the moment, though, it is Serbia, the defending champions from Rio, leading 6-3.
Back at some of the goals there from the first quarter. No change of ends for the second quarter, so it'll be Serbia still attacking the goal to the left in the dark blue swim caps. Dejan Savic, the man who played 444 times for Yugoslavia, Serbia and Montenegro and Serbia. It could be Papanastiou on the sprint for Greece. And Razovic once again for Serbia. Here we go then, second quarter in the gold medal match. The advantage with the Serbs, the defending champions at the moment. And it's Greece that get first control of the ball and the first 30-second segment to try and get themselves back into the game.
I need to pay respect to Papanastasiou by retrieving that ball, by trying to get on the scoreboard nice and early. Need to find a bit of structure in attack. Not sure if they're knowing what they're doing at this stage to find someone in the hole. You don't have to go to the hole. Instead, you can just pass the ball to the captain, Yanis Fontoulis, the 33-year-old, and he says, this is how we're going to do it.
Back to a two-goal game. Fontoulis played for Olympiakos for 10 years before moving on to Ferencváros in Hungary.
That's another bunny shot. We've seen a few of those throughout the tournament. Ball that's thrown at very quick pace towards the goalkeeper's head. Great stuff from the captain, Fontoulis. It's just what the doctor ordered for Greece, trailing Serbia by 2 goals.
Need to defend, they need to be disciplined, Greece. They need to just keep their shape and not commit those exclusion fouls. Serbia will punish you. Oh, wow, that's outside 6 metres, well outside from Mandic. The pace on that ball, it was past Zadivas before he could even move.
Outstanding stuff from Mandic. In his semi-final, he was 3 from 3, and he does like to score them from a distance. Near impossible there for Zadavis to try and stop. Hasn't had the best start to the game, has the young goalkeeper from Greece. Very early in the match at this stage, but 15 from the tournament for Mandic. And there's a word of warning from the Serbians. We can score from anywhere, from just about anyone playing in the pool, be it up close. The defence is good on the whole set, then we'll score 6 metres out. Here come the Greeks, pressure on to try and claw their way back in this match. Nothing in the middle, shot clock counting down. Went for the bounce shot, but it wasn't accurate enough and bounced over the back of the cage.
Another opportunity passes Greece by. They trail by three still. Just a couple of goals in this second quarter. So far, Filipovic on the ball, the left-hander. Much better angle for the left-handers from that far side of the pool if you're going cross-cage.
I was just going to say there's a couple of left-handed opportunities there for... That looked close, didn't it, for Serbia. We've got the captain, Filipovic, and also Mandic, who is on fire at the moment. So when they're out there together, it certainly makes the defenders second guess as to what they're doing and where they're going. Here come the Greeks through Vlachopoulos. Turnover.
Turnover foul by Marikis in that centre forward position. So another possession handed back to the defending champions. Good save, Zadivas. Didn't have to move very far for that one. It's another shot with pace, though. Mandic again.
Great save. He's got his eye in now. Takes a little while sometimes, the nerves settling in. His first Olympic Games for Zadivas. Surrounded by Olympic champions in his team and within the opposition. So much experience in this Serbian outfit. Nice passing from Greece. Great shot. Top left-hand side of the goal. Outstanding stuff from Vlachopoulos. There we go. The Greek fans are excited. They have the flags and they're sensing something special within two goals now.
Yeah, Vlachopoulos just inside that post. I was about to say earlier that they don't have any left-handed players, which narrows their options. That's a right-handed shot where you perhaps think the angle would be a little bit too tight, but Vlachopoulos has executed it perfectly into that top corner.
That's more what we know of Greece, is to back themselves and show confidence in the shot. Then they hold back. Theo Vlachos there, not so pleased with what's happening out there. But when they hold back and show hesitancy, they second-guess themselves. And they show faith in their shot and their attacking plays. And they've got plenty of them from Greece. And on the back of that, you've got Zadivas, whose eye is now in the game. This is starting to change. We sense a momentum shift in this gold medal match. Not a problem there for the young goalkeeper.
Yeah, not relatively unorthodox. He just stuck out his elbow and flicked the ball away. So they all count. Anyway, Greece coming forward looking to take us back to a one-goal game again. They've got a bit of momentum going now. There's a foul in the 2-metre area once again. So they will have the extra player. And they have got another goal. It's Kovetsis that's brought us back to 7-6.
Two fists in the air for Kovetsis, his first Olympic Games. 35 matches for his country. That's what I'm talking about, backing yourself, showing confidence. Don't second guess. If there's no one to pass through in the middle, you've got the power, you've got the strength, and now you're getting past Mitrovic. Great stuff from Greece. The bench love it. The few fans that are here, that are workers from around the stadium or sports people that have finished their Olympic campaign, totally entertained by that one from Kovetsis. Here we go, within one now, Greece. How can Serbia retaliate?
Still a long way to go in this first half as well, over 4 minutes still. So Serbia back on the attack, looking to create a little bit of space. Turnover foul, so Greece with a chance to progress once again. It's Dusko Pietlovic that's been penalised. Greece have scored the last two goals without reply. Can they get a third to level us up at 7-all? Not much to choose between either side in this gold medal match, as you would expect at this stage of a competition.
No surprise, Filip Filipovic, the captain from Serbia, has been re-injected into the game. He is one of the best defenders, and they need a best defender if they're going to shut down Alejandro Papanastasiou. He is 22 years of age. You can see the momentum shift, and it's not just from the scoreboard. It's the way they're passing, and showing confidence and backing themselves to take it straight into the back of the cage.
Beautifully placed into the corner for Papanastasiou, and there'll be a timeout called by Dejan Savic. So clearly not happy with what's going on with his team at the moment. They've conceded the last three goals. They were in a 6-3 lead at the end of the first quarter. They got to 7-4 up, but now they've been pegged back to 7-all.
Thanks to that last goal by Papanastasiou. I mentioned he's 22. He does stand 6'4", pretty close to 2 metres. His father, Anastasiou, played for Greece at 4 Olympics. He played a few seasons also in Croatia. That's what the coach wants. He's given instructions to his Serbian players. You're up by 3, and now take a look at the scoreboard. We do have a match on our hands for this final game of men's water polo at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre. And at this stage, the upper hand is with Greece.
Dejan Savic, very experienced, of course. He led Serbia to 5 successive World League superfinals. Gold medal 5 years ago. They took a bronze in London. It's a rare exclusion, actually, for Greece in this second quarter. They've been really disciplined at the back, but it's Agaropoulos that's been excluded. So Serbia with an immediate chance to get back in front with the extra player.
Great defence. Excellent defence from Greece.
Working the ball around the cage. It's hit Zavdivas in the face, but he won't care too much about that. He's kept the ball out the net. That's what counts.
Inspirational defence from the Greek players. They were down a player in the first quarter. I'm sure the Serbians would have scored that. They've decided to approach the player with the ball sooner, not letting that player have any time to pass. So here come the Greeks. No issue for them at this stage. Playing with a tremendous amount of confidence, loving having the ball in hand. And we will lose a Serbian player, who is the captain, Filip Filipovic, for 20 seconds.
So Greece with an immediate chance here to continue their excellent momentum psychologically against the Olympic champions to get back to 7-all. Will give them a massive boost, but they can't find a way past Branislav Mitrovic on this occasion.
That time he proved why he is one of the greatest keepers in the world. He knew exactly where the ball was going, lifted up both hands and denied them. Very important save for Branislav Mitrovic.
It's living up to its billing as a gold medal match at the moment, that's for sure. We're approaching half-time. That'll be a foul. Oh, it's a turnover foul. I was about to say Mandic has been fouled, but it's a turnover foul by Dusan Mandic. So Randalevic is on 2 fouls now, 1 more and he's out the match.
They need him. He's one of their key defenders. It's his second Olympic Games for Randalevic. Scored 3 goals in the tournament, but defensively has been one of the better players for Serbia. So he needs to settle down, keep an eye on the defence. The field defence at the moment strong. Too much pressure then. No way through for Kapotsis, so the Serbians with an opportunity to attack.
Greece haven't led since they scored the opening goal of the game from Skoumpakis. They've definitely got themselves back into the game. There's another exclusion. It's Papanastasiou that's been excluded this time, so 6-on-5 press from Serbia once again. So Divas just trying to hold his position. Serbia working the ball around the cage, and that ploy of just trying to push the ball in with the pace on the cross has gone wide from Dusko Pietlovic.
It was an exact replay of the goal in the first quarter that the Serbians scored. Pietlovic gets nice and high, but this time not as accurate. Great defence, excellent work from the Davis. He knew where it was going because it was a replay of that initial goal. So inspirational things coming from the keeper, and that's as good as scoring a goal sometimes. The captain's back in the game for Greece, Fontoulis. Denied that time was Columbus.
I think the whistle had already gone. It was a turnover foul from Vlachopoulos before Greece managed to get the shot in. Saved anyway by Branislav Mitrovic. So just over a minute to go in the first half. We're back to where we started, all square. Trying to find some space inside that whole area just in front of the cage. That's a turnover once again, so Fontoulis with a steal.
The bench not very happy with that. The bench from Serbia saying that was definitely a foul. He hit him in the head and grabbed the ball over his shoulder. The referees that are very experienced and they're in control with the whistles thought different. Now an opportunity with 30 seconds remaining before half-time. Can Greece take the lead? They haven't been in front since early in the first quarter. Denied that time with a deflection. We are 7-7.
Ball bouncing away. So Vlachopoulos unable to capitalise on their possession. Exclusion foul right at the end of the first half here, so a chance for Serbia. It's Fontoulis that's excluded, and Serbia retake the lead.
Kalanovic, so much power. They didn't expect that. They didn't expect him to shoot from that far out. He kept the ball so low, still deflected off the water, straight over the arm of Zervatis. Very difficult to stop. Great shot. What a perfect time to do it with 4 seconds remaining before halftime.
Andrea Perlanovic with the goal, fourth Olympic Games. Top scorer in London in 2012, 22 goals to his name. Shot right on the stroke of halftime before the hooter, pushed away by Mitrovic. Oh, what a heart, what a quarter that was, rather. 6-3 going into it. Greece got themselves level. Serbia with that goal have got the edge at halftime in the gold medal match. It's Greece 7, Serbia 8.
Just 16 minutes of play remaining until we find out the gold medalists from Tokyo 2020. Shot saved, 5 apiece for both keepers, 5 from 13 for Jeff Davis, and also 5 from 12 for Mitrovic. Nothing in it in the first quarter. Serbia winning 6-3, raced away in the second half of that first quarter. And then in the second quarter, Greece, with an outstanding state of play for 3 minutes, managed to fight back to win that one 4-2. Get some energy on board now. It's an expansive, energetic game, always working on defence and attack. A few words of wisdom from both coaches, Dusan Savic and also Theodoros Vlachos. They know what their team needs to do to win gold for their country.
So Serbia bidding for a second successive gold medal at the Olympic Games against Greece in their first final. And they traded goals. Serbia did get themselves an advantage, but Greece fought their way back into things.
It was a different story towards the second quarter. First quarter was dominated in the second half by Serbia. And the second quarter came along and the Greek players decided to back themselves in attack. So we saw the captain, Yanis Fontoulis, secure 1 from 2. A 100% success rate for Papanastasio, 1 from 1 at this stage. They're sharing the goal scoring. Lachopoulos, the one with 2 from 3. Kuvetsis and Kolumbis also on the scoreboard. I think the Greek side have learnt from that second quarter that if they do decide to back themselves and there's an opportunity to have that shot at goal, it won't go in every time, but if you can try and find Ranislav Mitrovic napping occasionally, which won't happen a lot, then the opportunities are there and the points can be taken. A much better performance from Zadavis in that second quarter. He certainly got his eye in, just 23 years of age, and feeling the Olympic pressure, not just from himself or his teammates, but for the 13 million Greek people watching him. What a half it's been for this gold medal match.
So, change of ends at half-time. So, Greece will play from right to left in the second half in the white swim caps. Serbia in the dark blue. There goes the hooter. We're on the referee's whistle now. It will be Papanastasiou. Razovic once again for Serbia.
So Greece with an opportunity to mount the first attack early in the second half. So many of these players know this quarter can often be the championship quarter, and the benefit of getting the race to the ball and winning that means you get to attack first. It's a shame off the top of the cage. That would have been a wonderful opportunity for Greece to level things up. It's always a confidence booster if you can score first after the halftime break.
So they've shown great character, the Greeks, by coming back from that three-goal deficit. Dejan Savic not happy with his team that they'd allowed Greece back into the match. But they won't want to have to chase those deficits too often. That one goes flashing wide of the cage.
That was very good defence. That defence forced the wide shot. Milanovic, another one with two strikes beside his name, three, and you're out. That defence was inspirational that time. The shot clock was counting down and they were playing a player-on-player defence, not a zone defence, so they're moving out to the player with the ball. That might be an exclusion foul, yep. Say goodbye. 20 seconds in the sideline. So an opportunity here for Greece to level things up. Attacking from the middle. Looking for space. The whole set's covered. No one in the middle. Anyone shooting from wide, deflection too good. Mitrovic says, keep trying. Keep coming. It's not good enough.
Yeah, love the goalkeepers, the way they just taunt the other players. We've seen that a lot in this competition. The likes of Victor Nagy and Lopez from Spain. These two up there among the best goalkeepers in the water polo here in Tokyo this year. It's just a little bit wayward. That's going to be turned over, and a look of disgust from Aleksic on the pass that was deflected on its way to him. So it goes behind and Greece will come forward once again.
Once again, they can herald the defence, which has been outstanding in the last two sets of play. But they need to turn defence into attack. Got the opportunity. It's a good shot, better deflection. No way through Mitrovic at this stage.
So Greece trail by one. Serbia on the ball. Filipovic. Exclusion for Fontoulis again, so that's two fouls for him. Serbia working the ball and working those defenders. That's gone over the line. The goal line judge has given the goal. VAR might want to double check that one.
It was nice teamwork from Mandic to Razovic. They passed it across the face of the cage three times. Just taunting the keeper. I think that did go under his arm, and I think it did cross the goal. It was nice passing from Serbia then.
Yeah, I think you're right. Seeing it from that angle, the ball definitely went over the line. It's always going to try and get away with it. Zadivas, it's another goal for Mandic. So Greece find themselves trailing by two once again.
This is a danger period for Greece. Early in the third quarter, Serbia with a two-goal lead. They're in possession. They seem to have gained some finesse in attack. You knew I was going to say gained some finesse in attack, not lost it. Finally, they're managing to find a centre-forward, this time through Morkrikis. He is massive. 6'5", that's 198 centimetres tall, 33 years of age, too much power, too much strength, and placed himself perfectly. So it's working in the middle at the moment for Greece, and such an important goal as we approach the midway point of this third quarter. Plenty of time to go. He gets a break, does Morikis. 4 from 12 in the tournament so far. We'll see him again. Very effective in the whole set.
Yeah, Morikis getting that important goal that's pulled Greece, and they're certainly outnumbering the Serbians in the arena. It is just team delegates and other team members that are here. No spectators allowed, of course, in Tokyo this year, which is a real shame because this would have been one that was very difficult to get tickets for, the gold medal match. It's always one of the most important or most popular sports at an Olympic Games.
Water polo, the oldest team sport at the Olympics, and the Greeks are attempting to win their first gold medal in a team sport at any Olympics. Up until now, they'd never won a medal in men's water polo. Great save. Excellent stuff. Inspirational from Zadavis. They know they have a silver at a minimum. They want something shinier. They want something golden to take home to Greece.
Fifth save made by Zadavis. Same number as his opposite number, Branislav Mitrovic, at the other end. Here come Greece again. Long-range shot from 6 metres goes over the top. Couldn't find a way through.
A little ambitious, I think, that time from Papanastasiou. No opportunity there. The captain, Yanis Fontoulis, he will be the flag bearer at the closing ceremony. He has 2 strikes beside his name in the game of water polo. You're allowed 3. They need their captain, one of the better defenders and also the second highest goal scorer for Greece. Going from end to end at this stage, and the keepers are doing their part. What a game on our hands at the moment with Serbia leading Greece in this all-important gold medal match.
Kvetsis, who got his hand to that before it was needed to be saved by Zadavis. Here come Greece again into the hole. That will be another exclusion. It's Mandic, who's got a couple of goals to his name, that's now going to sit out for a while.
Time out.
Timeout called by Theodoros Vlachos.
A nice opportunity for the players to have a break. There's some discussion going on between Vlachos and the referees. I think he was arguing it shouldn't have just been an exclusion. I think he was saying that one of his centre forwards might have been Kvetsis was trying to shoot, but it doesn't matter now. The referees have made their decision, so no penalty throw, but an exclusion. That one skims straight in some of the finer moments of the opening stages of this gold medal match between two of the powerhouses, the defending champs Serbia, up against a new-look Greek side. They came to these Olympics in a rebuilding phase and have now found themselves challenging the Serbians for a gold medal. Serbia leading 9-8.
So time out for the instructions. Let's see what Greece can do. Let's see if the tactics work here with the extra player as they try to draw level once again. Into the top of the cage via the goalkeeper's hand. It's another goal for the captain, Ioannis Fontoulis. 9-all.
Very popular member is the captain, Ioannis Fontoulis. That looked effortless then from the 33-year-old captain. Great passing. Obviously, the timeout worked. Knew exactly what was happening. So much power on the ball. I mean, Branislav Mitrovic was there. He was there to stop it. But just too much power from the captain. Outstanding stuff from the number 5. Inspirational stuff. 9-all. Nothing in it.
As we said earlier, it's certainly living up to its billing as a gold medal match. Serbia looking for their second successive goal off the foot of the post and gathered in by Zadavis. So another one passes them by, Dusko Pietlovic.
Sometimes there's a little luck in the game of water polo. Slight deflection from Zadavis, just a slight one off the left hand, and then the mighty friend of the goalkeeper, the cage, came in for the complete deflection. An opportunity here for Greece to take the lead for the first time in a long time. Not going to happen.
As we said, Greece haven't been in front since they scored the opening goal of the game right at the beginning of the first quarter. It's been Serbia that edged in front, got into a 3-goal lead. It was clawed back by Greece, and Serbia have always managed to get themselves back in front again. 2:30 left in the third quarter. Bit of space here, and push wide once again. In fact, it's not been pushed wide by the goalkeeper because it's possession turned over to Greece.
Beautiful defence from Georges Nervisis. He is just 26 years of age. It was because of him that ball went wide. That was outstanding stuff. Really surprised that we haven't seen a lot of Araropoulos in this game. He only played 12 minutes in the semi-final. He has been just been brought in. Played 12 minutes but scored 4 goals from 6 attempts. So he spent some time on the bench. Now he's out there and they'll be looking for him. He is an attacking weapon, one of the better attackers in this competition, and they'll look for him to take the lead in this match against Serbia.
6-on-5 play for Greece. Nikola Jakšić excluded into the 2 metres. They've got a real chance here off the goalkeeper and onto the bar. Although he's claiming he didn't touch it. He did take a touch off Branislav Mitrovic. They're back to a full complement here. Serbia.
Goalkeepers certainly don't lie, do they? I didn't do it. Didn't touch my hands straight off the top of the cage. So.
Well, the referees disagree because it is still Greece possession. Nice try. Foul by Aleksic. Not an exclusion foul, though. A little battle going on there just in front of the goalkeeper. Greece working the ball into centre-forward. There's the turnover foul, though.
I think he crept in the 2-metre mark. You're not allowed to be in that 2-metre mark just in front of the goalkeeper if you don't have possession. So he would have been pretty close to that. It was unfortunate for Greece because he did actually find some space and look to have an opportunity. I thought he might have opted for the backhand, but here comes Serbia. Ball in hand, going across the face. Oh, lovely short ball. Great teamwork. Outstanding stuff from the captain, Filipovic. He found Prodlanovic, his 34-year-old buddy. They're both 34 years of age. And between the two of them, the veterans, outstanding staff showing their experience there, playing like it's their first Olympic Games, not their fifth.
It's Serbia back in front once again. Can they hold the lead this time? There's still a full quarter to go. Disappointed with his side's defending, allowing Serbia through there. Prodlanovic getting his second goal of the gold medal match.
He got the pass from the captain. Between the captain, Filipovic, and Prodlanovic, they've played close to 1,000 games for Serbia. How about that? There's experience for you. They know each other inside out. Exclusion foul. So they say goodbye to Aleksic for 20 seconds. Opportunity here for Greece. This is the time to strike. When they're a player down, somewhere is open. Someone is free. Who's going to take it? Great deflection.
Brilliant stop by Mitrovic. They worked the ball, but the defenders in the middle made sure there was no space in at centre. Big stop.
What a quick third quarter it's been. Just 23 seconds remaining in it. What a time for Zervados to make a save as well. Come on now, the coaches are saying. Frustration is setting in for both of them, for Vlachos and Snitch.
So, last 5 seconds, they'll have to get a shot in here. Greece just off the post again. Very nearly right at the end of the third, they got a goal back. Well, we're 3/4 of the way through the gold medal match, and it is the defending champions that have just edged in front once again. It's Greece 9, Serbia 10.
There's nothing in this gold medal clash between Serbia and Greece. Serbia leading by 1 goal. They're all locked up in that third quarter, though. It was 2 apiece. Greece raced away to a 4-2 win in that second quarter, but the Serbians with a 6-3 win, so nothing in it, just 1 goal. We'll see that change a fair bit in this last quarter. Some exceptional saves from both goalkeepers, so Davis from Greece and also Branislav Mitrovic, the 36-year-old from Serbia. They'll be peppered a lot in the final quarter. No time for second guesses. No second chances now. This is the chance to win a gold medal. They can't leave anything behind. Greece chasing their first gold medal in a team sport. Serbia attempting to win two in a row at Tokyo 2020.
So 8 minutes remain in the gold medal match. Just four goals coming in that third quarter. Things are starting to tighten up defensively. It's going to be Dedovic this time on the swim off for Serbia and Papanastasiou for Greece.
Well, he's the one to beat in the swim-off, isn't he? Papanastasiou. He's so young. It's his first Olympic Games, and they rely heavily on him to obtain first possession. So, Greece in the final quarter of this gold medal match, looking for opportunities to getting close to the centre forward. They swamped all over them, and as a result, will lose a player to an exclusion foul. So this is where the Greek players need to make it count. An opportunity with a power play, an extra player on attack. Defence will have to work hard. They'll have to double-team someone. They'll be kept napping. Meanwhile, the shot clock, is it at 5 seconds? Did it slot in? I think it did. Great stuff. Excellent work from Skoumbakis. He is just 22 years of age. He is the next breed of Greek water polo player. He was jolly on the spot. He had to work so hard to get away from the defenders. And once he received the ball, watch him just pop it in. Does it sneak in? It does.
Yeah, I thought the goalkeeper, Mitrovic, was just going to get across to that one. He didn't quite make the contact, but he's had a little bit of good fortune in front of the cage there, Skoumbakis.
Nice deflection. What an important save at this stage in the game. 10 apiece, Greece and Serbia. Nothing wrong with the shot. Plenty of defenders in front. Didn't deflect off anyone. Had to work hard for that, Zadavis. He would have been obstructed. His sight would have been difficult to see the ball from the players in front of him. That's inspirational stuff. What can Greece now do with the ball? Can they take the lead in this gold medal match? They have possession. Confidence is brimming.
As we said, they haven't led since the very first goal of the match when they took the lead through Skoumbakis, but it's been Serbia ever since, and they've been blocked there. Randalovic, no further part for him after the three fouls. Mandic getting the initial rebound, and Prolanovic playing the ball forward. It's going to be a penalty. Skoumbakis with a little tug back, denying the goal-scoring opportunity. So a chance for Serbia from the penalty. Filipovic scored one earlier on. It's going to be Prolanovic this time. So difficult for the goalkeepers to try and save these. They are 100%. Greece, 90% Serbia. And there's another one into the back of the cage. And Serbia take the lead once again.
Great shot for Alanovic. He loves the 5 metre shot. They practice it every day. Four key players they pick. This is the action under the water. They use their whole body to get some strength to try and get it past the keep. It was a big task then for Zadavis. And they really had to impose the foul because, to be fair, he was going to score anyway. So the penalty shot in favour of Serbia. They take the lead in the fourth quarter over Greece, 11-10. Greece in possession now. looking for their perimeter players. They've done well with their swimming game. Not many diversions from Greece to try and draw the defenders in, but they haven't had to draw it. They've just relied on their centre forward to try and escape the clutches of Bedovic. He'll spend some time out. Great opportunity here to make it all level.
Exclusion for Dusan Mandic, so a chance for Greece to level once again with the extra player. They need to keep hold of the ball. It's almost stolen in front of the cage and fired over the top. The chance is gone.
That's off to Polanovic. He scored a goal at the other end. It's the action under the water, and he comes back and saves two. Puts pressure on two shooters then. We watch him reach forward in the number 11 cap with his right hand. It was great pressure from a guy who had just scored a goal. That's inspirational from Serbia. Zetlovic is back on, so is Razovic and Jakzic. So all their key attackers have come back on. And meanwhile, Greece lose Devisis for 20 seconds. Look out, here comes Serbia.
Yeah, another goal now for Serbia, and a two-goal cushion would be tricky at this stage for Greece to try and claw back. Just need to have to right in front of them. They're not going to miss that one, though. Pushed into the goal by Jakzic from close range. That's the second time he scored from that position in the game. And he's got another one here to put Serbia now into a two-goal lead.
It was an identical setup from the last goal. Exactly the same, from Mandic to Filipovic to the short ball. Reach up high. Jakzic there, so high, so much power. Can't be denied. They want to shut that down, Greece. They know the ball is going to go from 2 to 10 across the face and give an opportunity for the centre forward to jump up and celebrate that one.
Turnover again. That's just getting away from Greece a little bit at the moment. It was Murikis with the steal. With a turnover foul, sorry, that's handed possession back to Serbia. And now Filipovic to move the 2016 gold medal winners forward. They've still got possession of the ball. A third goal now, and you wonder how Greece will get back in. It's up to them to have come back from three already. There's another foul, Genedunias excluded.
Got to watch the middle here. This is where it's working for Serbia. From perimeter to perimeter, from wing to wing. And then Filipovic finds the short ball, nullified that time by, off the cage, around the cage, in the goal. Serbia take a three-goal lead.
Well, they're pulling away again now. And the clock is running away from Greece, unfortunately. We've only got under 4 minutes to go. Well, just around about 4 minutes to go now in the final quarter.
Great diversion there from Serbia. Their centre-back pretending to shoot instead offsetting. Reality's starting to settle in. Still plenty to be played, but with each goal comes the hope of a golden moment.
Dusan Mandic with the goal. Is it a goal that's sending Serbia to another gold medal, I wonder? Oh, Greece's heart's going to be broken, having never won a medal in Olympic water polo. There's an exclusion against Dedovic. So they've scored. Well, they've taken it quickly. The ball's ended up in the back of the cage, but I don't think it's going to count. They're going to have to restart, I think. Not much Dejan Savic can do, just looking on from the sidelines. Greece need to make their player advantage count here. They have to score, you would feel, from this attack. Another good save. Big hand by Mitrovic.
Could possibly be the save of the night. Not even in terms of technique, but in terms of timing. The growls. Right there, and then Greece had to score. 3 minutes remaining in possession. A player excluded. Trailing by three, they had to score, and they were denied by one of the greatest goalkeepers we have ever seen.
Backhand, good save. Zadivas had to react quickly to that one. Tremendous pace on those backhand shots that these players can generate. Years of practice to perfect that effort. A There's another turnover. So the turnovers, Marikis again, second turnover foul in quick succession from him. Serbia back on the attack, looking in control at the moment. They can just start to run the clock down now. There's no need to get a shot in until that clock ticks down to the last couple of seconds. You can run the 30 seconds off when you've got the ball. You've just got to then defend, and they're quite happy just to give the ball away. Just played into Prolanovic. Not much pace on the pass. He was able to.
Here we go. Greece have to score. Their enemy is the clock, running out of time. Someone will be excluded. So not only do they have possession, Serbia are down a player. This is where it's fallen down in the last 5 minutes for Greece. They get here good enough. Setting things up. Their whole set, their two centre forwards just can't escape the clutches of the blue cap defence. 5 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Looking for the short ball, centre forward couldn't get free. No exclusion foul. Possession with Serbia.
We're inside the final 2 minutes. The Serbians that are here are sensing gold once again. I'm sure they feel now that the job is done. Greece aren't going to get three goals in 90 seconds, barring some kind of major miracle. Serbia with an attempt, one more attempt on goal maybe. A chance in at centre forward. The clock's turned over before Jakšić could get the shot in. He felt he'd been fouled. Timeout called. Just to add to the agony here, timeout called by Serbia.
It hasn't been an easy run to the finals for Serbia. They opened the tournament with a loss to Spain by one goal, 13-12. And they also faced defeat at the hands of Croatia, 14-12. So that was the start of the tournament for them. Lots of water polo critics were saying they wouldn't make it through to the gold medal. And if they did, they would be outclassed by this Greek team full of youthful enthusiasts, the new breed of water polo players. But Serbians have certainly put in their best performance so far at these Olympics in defence and attack. Their structure on attack has been the most impressive we've seen throughout the tournament, and they've improved from the quarterfinals to the semi-finals to this gold medal match.
Well, they knew they'd have to be at the top of their game to beat Greece, who they celebrated like they won the gold when they got through the semi-final, because they knew they were guaranteed their first medal at an Olympic Games. It looks as though it's going to be silver. They have performed exceptionally well at these games once again, but the defence from Serbia at the moment is strong. They've battled hard when they've needed to, and it's another block in front of the keeper by Jakšić.
They're pumped at the moment, Serbia. I know, with a minute remaining, and unless something very strange happens, the medal will be theirs. Worked hard as a team, so many of their experienced players. You've got Zetlovic, Aleksic, Filipovic and Kladlanovic all at their fifth Olympic Games. They know what it's like to win. They know what it's like to lose a medal. And at the moment, they are the champions of the world, and they want to become Olympic champions.
Jenna Dunias gathering the rebound in. Is there one more goal in this for Greece? Just to put a little bit of respectability on the score. It's fired wide of the cage by Agaropoulos, and the final 30 seconds. Surely now Serbia will just keep hold of the ball. They can keep it deep in their own half of the pool if they wish. They don't need to get the ball forward. They can celebrate on the sidelines. Dejan Savic, the man who's guided them to a second successive gold. It's tough on Greece, who made a game of it. They trailed by three in the middle section of the game, but got back to level things up. And then there was only ever one goal in it until Serbia managed to get themselves in front towards the end of that fourth quarter. Filipovic celebrates another gold medal. And those experienced players, those four five-time Olympians in the Serbian ranks, have helped them through to Olympic gold for the second consecutive games. It's a brilliant performance in the end. They know they've been in a game. Credit to Greece for the part they've played, not just in the final, but also in the tournament as well. They've made us smile on a lot of occasions with the quality of their play, but ultimately Serbia proved strong and they rule supreme once again, and they will take some toppling from the top of men's water polo.
What a lovely moment between the two coaches, Savic and Velopoulos. It was the first and the final quarter for Serbia that nailed the victory. They did lead 6-3 at the end of the first quarter. Greece came back with a two-goal lead in the second quarter. They're all locked up in the third. And then an outstanding performance in the final quarter from Serbia to have their back-to-back wins. Celebrating. Wonderful moment with the coaching staff and the officials all thrown in the pool. Just like in the women's final. Apparently, Adam Krikorian had his mobile phone on him when he was thrown in the pool. And smiles all round for this Serbian side that entered the tournament under loads of pressure with a couple of losses. The critics were there. We weren't too sure what would happen in this gold medal match. And hats off to the Greek players. Six of their players attending the Olympics for the very first time. It was the fresh faces that performed exceptionally well. Both goal keeps, so Davis and also Mitrovic, played their part in representing their countries. So still rewriting the history books are the Greeks to take home a silver medal, but it will be Serbia with a 13-10 win over Greece to take the gold. Their extra player shots, 6 from 9, helped their cause. Excellent defence from the field and from the keepers. And as we take a final look, confirmation there, it is gold for Serbia for the second time in a row. Greece with a silver medal for the first time in men's water polo. And Hungary will take the bronze medal at Tokyo 2020.
So the best two teams that had battled their way through the water polo tournament met in the gold medal match. Greece against Serbia. There was nothing to choose between them until we got to the final quarter. At one point, Greece had trailed by 3. They got back level, and then it was all about who could hold their nerve and get themselves in front. Zadivas and Branislav Mitrovic were great in goal, but ultimately Serbia proved to be the stronger to win a second gold medal. Jakšić getting his second goal from close into the cage. And it was a final that definitely lived up to expectation.
Some sensational performances from the attackers from Serbia. Really impressive was Pjetlovic with 2 from 5 and managed to get his hand on the ball defensively as well. It was the field defenders that did so well for Serbia. The modern game has changed so much over the past decade. It's not just all about attack and power shots. It's about how you can shut the attackers down with an offensive zone, which works so well for the Serbians here. They didn't change from the game plan, and that was put pressure on the player with the ball. Even when Greece came within the draw and it was 7-all, they still didn't panic, did the former champions. And a show of respect for both coaches, and time to celebrate in the water as Serbia win this one against Greece 13-10.
So the players will make their way away to get themselves ready for the medal ceremony, which is coming up very soon. Familiar for Greece, who will be unfamiliar rather for Greece, who are getting their first medal, of course. There are the top scorers, Alexander Ivovic from Montenegro, finishing top, 53% scoring rate for him. Luka Bukic, Croatia, and Christian Manhurt taking up gold, silver, and bronze in that particular table, if you want to look at it that way. Jenna Dunias from Greece, and Fontoulis as well, while Mandic and Filipovic both made their way in there for Serbia. So we will have the medal presentation soon, but it is Serbia that take gold, Greece the silver, and Hungary the bronze.
This. Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du water polo homme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's water polo competition.
皆様、ただいまより水球男子の表彰式を行います。
Well, it's been a fantastic 16 days action here at the Tatsumi Water Polo Center. Our final match was the men's gold medal match, which concluded just a few minutes ago. And our three medal winners will now make their way to the podium. A little bit earlier on, Hungary managed to seal themselves a bronze medal after finishing fifth in the last two Olympics, aside with such a rich water polo history. The sadness of losing that semi-final was forgotten when that final hooter went, and they were able to celebrate victory over Spain. There are the gold medal winners. Serbia, second successive Olympics for them. Brilliant performance. They held off the challenge of a very stubborn Greece side who at one point managed to get back from three goals down. So they will go to the top, to the centre, to the top of the podium. And the Greeks, who've had such a wonderful tournament, but they just couldn't get over the line for the gold medal.
Yeah, the Greeks undefeated heading into the competition. Outstanding performances in the preliminary matches. Just a draw with Italy. First time ever that Greece has won a medal in men's water polo.
And it is just Greece's fourth medal at this Olympic Games as well.
The medals will be presented by...
Medal no zonte wa...
Monsieur Nenad Lalovic, membre de la commission exécutive du CIO Serbie.
Nenad Lalovic is an IOC executive board member. He comes from Serbia, so he'll be a happy man presenting the gold medal. And he's joined by Andrei Krukov, a FINA bureau member from Kazakhstan.
Monsieur Andrei Krukov, membre du bureau de la FINA, Kazakhstan.
Don't forget these players as well have played every day. We talk about the conditioning and the strength of water polo and how much it takes out of you, but they've played every 2 days and they deserve some sort of credit for that as well.
Spare a thought for the Spanish side that didn't manage to find a place on the podium. They did come out after that bronze medal clash and said they were totally exhausted at the end of 8 days of complete competition.
So Hungary, led by their inspirational captain, Denis Varga, who fittingly scored in that bronze medal match before being excluded for three personal fouls. It's his fourth Olympic Games. He's on 47 Olympic goals now. Will he manage to see it through to see if he can reach a half century in Paris in 3 years' time? 9-5, Hungary beat Spain.
Victor Nudge
was excellent, and he has announced his retirement, and he'll be a big loss. He's been such an inspiration. When you look at, I almost wanted to suggest a Victor Nudge camera and just have it on him the whole time, because he was fantastic.
It was so touching at the end of that bronze medal Christian match when the team surrounded him in the middle of the pool and all patted him on the head. There were tears from the champion goalkeeper, and yes, he has indicated that he will not be back for international play anymore. This will be his last Olympics, and what a way to go out, a bronze medal for the Hungarians after finishing fifth in Rio and fifth in London.
Matthias Pastor.
I'm sure there's plenty more successes around the corner for Hungary. 9 Olympic golds in the past.
So dominant in the world of water polo. The women's team also successful in taking a bronze medal at these Olympic Games. They've dominated since the inclusion of the men's game in 1900 and the women's game in 2000. This evening, though, at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre, it was the Hungarians with an outstanding performance from some very brave Spanish players so that they could stand on this podium and present each other with bronze medals.
So, of course, the new way to present medals in the team sport now, with the social distancing and the protocols in place, each team member presenting the medal to their teammate, and the little mementos of an Olympic Games as well, something to take home. They've had some wonderful memories, Disappointment, obviously, at not making the gold medal match, Hungary, but delighted in the end to have come out winners and not be leaving empty-handed. Unlike the Spanish, of course, you have to feel for them. Nobody likes to lose a bronze medal match. Hungary, though, after two fifth-place finishes, are back on the podium.
Medaille d'argent, Grèce.
Silver medalists, Grèce.
And it's hard to believe when you look at Greece and you think how many Olympic participations they've had, 16. They've never finished better than fourth place.
Yeah, and that fourth place was in Athens in 2004. It's been a long time between celebration for the Greek players. Done oh so well in this situation. They came out at the end of their semi-final victory and said that they didn't want to celebrate too much because at the moment there's some catastrophic fires happening in Greece. Thousands of buildings and homes have been destroyed by those fires in several regions, mainly Attica, north of Athens. Lives have been lost, and Greek players said that they would dedicate this performance to those that are suffering back home, just for their teammates or for the 13 million Greek people, but especially for those battling those fires in their homeland.
Looking their way down the team. There are 13 medals given out this year to the extra man in the squad for this competition. Special dispensation by the IOC. Konstantinos Smirikas there. Christodoulos Kolumvos will get his medal in his second Olympic Games.
Konstantinos Giovetsis.
And finally, Angelos Vlahopoulos gets his medal.
Konstantinos Galanidis.
Certainly one of the sentimental favourites, this Greek side, taking on the world's best throughout the 16-day tournament. Went into the finals undefeated, just with a draw against Italy. A sensational performance, and certainly challenged the Serbians in this gold medal match. There are our silver medalists for men's water polo, Tokyo 2020, Greece.
Tremendous memories to take away with them. But Serbia will step to the top of the podium. It's a third gold medal for Serbia at this 32nd Olympiad. A ninth medal in total. And a second successive gold medal, having triumphed in Rio when they beat their great rivals Croatia in the final. Today they've held off the challenge of Greece. And they are the gold medal winners. And some of those five-time Olympians, the four five-time Olympians that are in their side, have another gold medal to celebrate. I just wonder how many of those will come back for a sixth appearance. Filip Filipović once again led by example. And they will take some beating. We've got the World Championships coming up later in the year. They will be the side to beat.
How outstanding was Filip Filipović throughout the whole tournament? It was his semi-final performance, the last 30 seconds of that match against Spain. In fact, 26 seconds remaining on the clock when he rose above the defenders to win the game for Serbia and make sure they went on their merry way to this gold medal match. It hasn't been without challenge, though. They did face defeats early in the round, and the critics said that maybe their heyday had passed them. A lot of critics said they weren't able to go back-to-back gold medals, obviously. Champion performance in Rio 5 years ago and have backed it up again in Tokyo. This is a magnificent moment for this very tight-knit Serbian team.
Nikola Jakšić,
third time at the Olympic Games for him.
Filip
Filipović needs no introduction. Over 650 international appearances, and that gold medal will feel just as special as all the other accolades he's won over the years.
Andreja Puljanović. Branislav Mitrović.
Still growling, still happy.
That's the goalkeeper, Branislav Mitrović. Saw a few of those when he made saves in that final.
He was inspirational for his team, not just this evening in the gold medal match, but throughout the whole tournament. Such a great leader, such a phenomenal goalkeeper. Keeps like it's his territory and so inspirational. When he stops a goal, it just gives his side an opportunity to counter-attack. And one of the leaders of this Serbian team, he's certainly admiring that gold medal. It means so much to him. It means so much to the players. In the last half a decade, what a campaign it has been for Serbia. They are on top of the world right now, and they belong on top of the podium.
So the gold medal winners, 13-10 victors over Greece in the final. Greece takes silver, Hungary take the bronze after their 9-5 win over Spain. And Serbia will hear their national anthem once more.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la Serbie.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Serbia.
皆様、セルビア国歌の演奏です。
Your anthem always sounds sweeter than Olympic Games, but it sounds even sweeter when you've got a gold medal hanging around your neck. Congratulations to Serbia, to Greece and to Hungary, who have all made the podium here in the water polo. Hungary, of course, got the bronze medal in the women's as well, so plenty of positives to take for Hungarian water polo out of their finishes. Serbia ruled supreme once again for a second consecutive Olympic Games. And they've brought a lot of pleasure to us over the last couple of weeks. So games every couple of days. I'm sure they'll be looking forward to go home to a well-earned rest. Of course, Olympic Games like no other, really, with the protocols and the extra measures that were put in place to keep everybody safe. And we've got through a team sport without any major issues. And that's a testament to everybody that's been involved in these Olympic Games in terms of keeping everybody safe. Serbia will make their way away then. They are the Olympic champions for a second consecutive Games. Hungary and Greece will have the memorable photos to take away with them. And we look forward to the water polo again in 3 years' time in Paris. It's been a pleasure here at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre over the last 2 weeks. We'll leave you with the world champions and now Olympic champions again, Serbia.
Congratulations again for Serbia. They defend their 2016 gold medals back to back. Well done, Serbia.